Okay, let's continue our lesson in Android Studio, and we talk about the Android Recycler View. This is the part 2. Okay, and this is my YouTube channel. As usual, you can find me over there. And please support me by like my Facebook page, Kusol Geek, and also follow me on Twitter and Kusol and GitHub as well. Okay, I talk about this already, and the step that I have done is this one and this one, just 4 and 7. So we still have 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. So we continue our lesson. Okay. And this is my YouTube channel. Please search me here. And or maybe just type my name like that. It's fine. Okay. Don't forget to subscribe. And this is my page. And just make a survey. You want to watch it in English, so please share and like it. So just like what you want to support me, okay? So I'm happy. If you don't support me, I feel sad. Yeah. Okay. So this is what we have done. We just created what's that? The card view and live view. Okay. So we need the so we need this number 2 and number 3 and the data. Okay, so here you want to create a class, so right click and choose new Java class, just a usual Java class, call it item. Okay, and you should implement serializable because later on you will use it to transfer from one activity to another. So it's a good practice that you should always implement serializable in Android. Okay, I'm not talking about Java, but I'm talking about class in Android. You should implement serializable like that. Okay, and then what else? This one, this is the ID, text, and image. Usually in Java, you when you want to create a field, you know, you create it like a setter and getter, like that. What's it? And then you have like public void set ID. Okay. And you set ID over here. This ID equal ID and integer get ID and you return this ID. Okay, it's just a typical setter and getter in Android in Java, but this one particularly I'm not using this kind of style because later on I will use this data, this class to map to the data that I get from JSON. And I use one of my library in the GitHub, and the library use another library from JSON. And JSON don't want you to use this kind of style. It wants you to use something like this, public in ID, okay? You don't have to create a setter and getter for it, just use public. It against the Java style, but it's fine for that, you know, because this like the JSON like this style better, you know. What else? Image, an image img here, just the URL for the image. Okay, so now you have the class item, okay, number 2. Now you need data number 1. Just like I said, we need the real data, but we don't have time for it. We just want to show something, and later on we will use the real data. But now, maybe just create a method, private, and I want to create a bunch of array lists. So, I declared it as the ArrayList like that, and the class here is the item that we just created. So ArrayList of item, So maybe just call generated dummy, something like that. Okay, and nothing. Now maybe just four. Yeah, it's like okay. Now I wanna run from i0 to i maybe 50, maybe i plus plus. So we're gonna create an item, and this is the big I and a small I. New item. So item ID for I because it's the integer, and text. So maybe just like dummy text, and I want to add I just to make it different. And image, that is the tricky one. You want to have the image. So now there are two ways. One, you can use this image, but to get that image from here, you use a simple method. But later on, we will not use the image inside your application. You can't store like 1,000 images. You're gonna make your application so huge and just only images, you know? So instead, you just get it from your, you know, like internet. So it's better just to call like that. Maybe I wanna have like waterfall. That's a good one, waterfall in Cambodia. Cambodia is my country. If you don't know that, you can come and visit. We have Angkor Wat, huh? If you don't know me, maybe you know this. You know this? This is my country, okay. So copy image address. You can see the URL has this, you know, like something after the image. So I don't want that. So I just want the real image here. Okay, now that's good. Copy. Oop. Okay, now you have this. Oop. Well, where is it? Okay, yeah. And then you need to add to ArrayList, but maybe you create an internal one. Just call this ArrayList. For this one, for Java 7, you use this, but Java 8, you don't have to use that. Just declare from the left, that's okay. And then you need to add to the list, okay? And after all, after you run like 50 times, then you just return it to the method, okay? So you return list. But now I want to make data more interesting, you know? Like this one, just one image, it's not gonna be fun. So I maybe want to create like different. So maybe like this, if I modular 2, maybe 3, call 0 is like 3, 6, you know, and then I wanna have like a different data, and L I modulus and modulus maybe what that 7 maybe, and then I have another data. And be 3, maybe 11, like prime number, and then maybe the rest. Okay, this is just the rest. So this one is gonna be Angkor Wat, but maybe some of the image, maybe Bayon, Cambodia. It's another temple, another popular temple. You know this, yeah. you have to wait until the loading finished here. If you pass like that, you cannot pass because you cannot copy. Google try to protect you. It's just like that. It's okay. So the second one, and maybe this one angle. So angle left, and this one by one. But the number is gonna be different here. One more, or maybe two more. So what else? This one, maybe. Copy. Okay. Something else. Something text. Yeah, whatever. The last one. Maybe something. It's not that, you know, modern city or whatever. It's just okay. Yeah. Loading. Okay. Copy. Looks good, right? Yeah, it's not bad. This is really. Okay, now you add it, but maybe you need to copy to each of the if condition. This one. Okay, now we get the data, so we're gonna pass it into array here. So maybe you create another array list here, something like item list, new array list, yeah, but just get the data directly. Okay, now we finish the step 3 and 1, okay, 1, 2, 3. And now this is the big thing, okay? So maybe you need to have the layout manager first. This is very easy, this one. So where is it? This one is the recycler view. Actually, card view, we don't have that. We don't need that. Just for example, in the last video, we just need the recycler view. And let's go back to the lesson, Android recycler view. This very good lesson here. You don't have to read another blog. It's gonna be good. But if you want to know more, maybe that I recommend this. So what else you need? This one, this layout manager. It's very easy after you get from the layout. And it said that if you have the fixed size, then you set to true, okay, to improve the performance, okay. So let's do it. Oh, we set, what's that, fixed size? Set has fixed size. Very strange name. Okay. Okay, so then layout manager. Layout manager, yeah. And I call manager new linear manager like that and this. Okay, so we use the linear layout manager, but actually we can use another like grid and stacker grid, you know. But this one is a very simple one. And I will talk about the layout in the next video. But now it's done now, yeah. Except we didn't set the layout yet, so set layout, okay, and manager, okay, and this one we gonna use it for the adapter, because the adapter is very huge and very complex. I want to make another video, it's like it's special for that, okay. So that's all. So this is what we need to do. we need the we need the item class. Okay, don't forget to use serializable. And then this data, just for example, we just create a dummy data, and in the future we use the real one. Okay, and what else? Manager, yeah, string. So that's all, and I will see you in the next video to talk about the adapter. Thank you.